Today we'll have analysis of sociological perspectives on wars. Hello friends, today we'll have analysis of sociological perspectives on wars. We know that how there is war going on between Israel and Palestine. So what sociology is saying about wars? One of the major perspectives of sociology, known as structural functionalism, given to us largely by Emile Durkheim, argues that wars, conflict, or any crime create anomic situations in our societies. Anomic situation refers to those actions which disturb the functioning of society. Because as per functionalist perspective, the major role of society is to maintain social stability and peace. Therefore, whensoever there is any hindrance in maintaining that peace, it is considered as anomic. It is considered as pathological, social ills. So this is one understanding of Durkheim on situations like wars. However, there is an interesting analysis given to us again by Durkheim that how even the crimes and the wars can promote something positive for society. So what is that positivity in wars? He argues that the crimes, the wars, which is even going on now between Palestine and Israel. So now this war is giving messages to others that this should be stopped. It is bringing chaos in society. It is ruining economical, political resources. It is killing people, innocent people, or the people who are involved, which is not good for maintaining social order. So even the crimes or even the situations like war is telling us that what should not be done in society. Another perspective is given to us by a conflict theorist who argues that all these conflicts such as wars, violence, it is basically coming out of specific interest. Like Karl Marx says that whatsoever we see, the conflict we see, it is only because of economical power. So one dominant group basically wants to achieve hegemony and control over economical resources so that that particular group can dominate and enjoys other privileges in our social world. So the war is only because of having control over means of production. It is not at all ideological. It is not at all about some personal or political interest. It is only because of economical base. Then we have another perspective, that is symbolic interactionism, perspective interactionism. Now this perspective is given to us largely by Max Weber. And Max Weber asks that we need to ask questions like why and how. What is its impact on individuals? Why wars actually initiates? Now, this perspective has specific analysis on micro questions. They'll try to see the factors which actually led to the development of such situations. And they also understand the meanings of war by different groups. So it means that it has multi perspectives. It'll try to understand similar situation by different dimension. So these are three major perspectives which analyzed in sociology by using different approaches, research methods, and then we conclude about wars or any situation which is actually creating a trouble in maintaining societies of the world. थैंक यू।